Tonight, Primetime can reveal that a former leading member of the Provisional IRA who was facing charges of sexually abusing a child has disappeared. The man, who's now 68 years old, had been extradited from Spain in 2016 to face four charges. He was subsequently granted bail, but it's believed he has fled the country. Our reporter Barry Cummins joins me now. Barry, what can you tell us?
Well, Dave, this news will cause significant concern in a number of quarters tonight. The case came to light initially when a woman walked into a Garda station in Dublin some years ago saying that she had been sexually abused by this particular man on four occasions in the early 1990s, a time when she was a child, but a time when Gardaí believed that this man was a very senior figure in the Provisional IRA in Dublin. This man is originally from Belfast but had been living in Dublin for a number of decades. And not only do Gardaí believe he was a senior member of the IRA in Dublin, but also a very significant figure in what was called the Southern Command of the IRA, which would have overseen IRA units in Dublin, in Leinster and in Munster as well. Now, Gardaí believe he was a very significant figure in 1994, the time that criminal Martin Cahill, known as the General, was shot dead in Dublin, a killing, I believe, carried out by the IRA. We know that this man left Ireland in 1996, shortly after Detective Garda Jerry McCabe was shot dead by the IRA in Adair in County Limerick. This man moved to Spain. He lived there for 20 years until he was extradited back to Ireland in 2016.
And what happened, Barry, after that extradition?
Well, he was brought back in April 2016 and brought before Dublin District Court, charged with four counts of sexual assault of a female. And at that time, Gardaí, having got him back to Ireland, objected to bail. They wanted him to stay in custody pending trial. They said they believed he was a flight risk. But the man posted a cash surety for bail, and he was granted bail. And he had to sign on at a Garda station in Dublin every single day. And he did. He honoured his bail conditions for over a year. 2 days before the trial was due to begin at Dublin Circuit Criminal Court in June 2017, the man vanished and he has not been seen since. And there's an alert out through Interpol to locate this man. Gardaí have been in touch with the Spanish police and other police forces as well. There's no sign of him. He's effectively in the wind. And of course, any person can disappear by themselves, can get out of Ireland, I imagine, on their own initiative. But you would have to ask, given the fact that he has not been found in the last 2 years, and he had a whole year to plan to go on the run, you would wonder, did he have help from any of his former colleagues in the Provisional IRA? What do they feel about this? And did they lend any assistance, or can they help to locate this man now who's wanted to face these four charges of sexual abuse? I should say that this particular case is being investigated by Gardaí in a North Dublin station. It's separate to the wider investigation that's ongoing into allegations of abuse against other members of the IRA.
Okay, Barry, thank you very much indeed for that. And no doubt we'll be keeping an eye on that story. Miriam.